I've got a confession to make. Sometimes I tell ChatGPT to act like it's Guilfoyle from Silicon Valley, just so it insults me while it helps me write CSS.
So Dinesh thinks this is you?
Correct. He's been messaging with it all day and he has no idea it's an AI.
Well, we fooled a human. I guess we just passed the Turing test.
I am all in on AI assistance. I use it from everything to writing CSS to winning arguments with my wife. But I want it in more places. In typical human fashion, I'm not satisfied to just go to one website to get the thing that I want. I want it everywhere. Particularly in the places where I work with other people, because let's be honest, ChatGPT can get a little lonely sometimes. So that brings me to Jigso Sidekick, which is going to allow me to use OpenAI's GPT-4 inside of Slack. And it gets better than that because you can actually connect your applications like Zendesk, Jira, or Salesforce and chat directly with your data. There's a ton more integrations coming too. I'm not sure I'm supposed to talk about them, but they're going to be adding support for things like Gmail, Notion, Monday, and Pipedrive very soon. Next up, it's demo time. I'm gonna connect Sidekick up to my work Slack and we can see all of the features in action. If you wanna follow along with me, Jigso is totally free and there's a link in the description. My thanks to Jigso for sponsoring today's video. All right, let's go. Let's click add to Slack. And now it's time for permissions. Don't worry, it's an AI robot. It's not gonna leave a mess. And if you want it gone, just a couple of clicks and it's out of there. Installation is happening. Okay, installed. Let's go to Slack. Sidekick lives in your sidebar under apps. You can click over here and just start engaging. Now you can engage with Sidekick just like you would ChatGPT. You can have it tell you all about the history of CPUs or summarize an email into bullet points, but you can do so much more with it. Let me show you some of my favorite assistant-like features. Now remember that Sidekick can see everything inside of Slack, so we can ask very specific things. Like tell me if anyone mentions expense spending. All right, now I've told Sidekick it's gonna keep its ears open, and if anyone mentions expense spending, it's gonna let me know about it. I don't have to read every single Slack channel. Like for example, I've been monitoring the keyword uptime, and someone in the general channel just mentioned it right now. Uh-oh, the wife wants to know about uptime. Now, if you do have extremely busy channels that you wanna keep up with, but you just don't have the time to read every single message, Sidekick can help with that. You just tell it to summarize a channel and it'll do so. SUM is the shortcut for summarize, and then I'm gonna have it summarize the general channel. All right, it looks like people have been talking about their birthday plans as well as website uptime over in general. So it can be good to know. All right, now for the big stuff. Let's connect some apps so we can chat with our data right inside of Slack. I wanna start with Zendesk for support requests. So I'm gonna type in connect Zendesk and I'll hit send. Now we get a button here to connect up to Zendesk. I'll enter in my Zendesk URL and hit connect. Then I'll log in. And I'm good to go, I can jump back into Slack. So with Zendesk connected, I'm free to ask it questions about our support activity. I'll try their example, which is to ask how many tickets there are per assignee. So Sidekick is going out to Zendesk right now, getting the information that I want. It's gonna report back in just a second. All right, it came back with an image attached. Let's open it up. So here I get a list of all of the assignees and the number of tickets that they have. Let's find out how many open tickets there are. Okay, Sidekick is checking. Looks like there's just one open ticket, so that's really good news. I wonder what our average time to response is. Whew, our average response is almost 11 days. We gotta do better. Now, if any of these responses are important, like, hey, why is our response time 11 days? I can click right here and immediately share this info with someone else who might be able to take care of the problem. All right, next, let's connect Salesforce. Connect Salesforce. I love how everything's just kind of obviously intuitive. You don't really have to think about the language. All right, same thing as before. I need to open this up in my browser. I'll log in. All right, I'm authenticated. Let's go back into Slack. Sure enough, Sidekick already knows about Slack and it's given me a sample prompt here. Let's run this. It says, how many opportunities closed last week and what was their total amount? Whew, no opportunities last week and nothing closed. Well, let's try something else. How about last year? Surely there had to have been some business in the last year. All right, 7 deals closed with a total of $1,149. You can also ask Sidekick to analyze your spreadsheets. Like for example, here is essentially a directory of employees. Let's find out how many live in Austin. The format for this is super easy. You just paste in the URL for the Google Sheet and then ask the question right afterwards. Let's go. So even though I don't have Google Drive connected to Slack, Sidekick doesn't care. It can go out and read the document and it tells me we have 99 employees in Austin. The same sort of idea works for documents. Here we have a document, a bio about Michael Jordan. I'm going to find out what happened to him in 1984. So exact same format here. I've got the URL of the Google Doc and then my question follows. Send. And there we go. We learn, of course, that in 1984, Michael Jordan was drafted by the Chicago Bulls and picked number 3. So there you go, just a small fraction of all of the things you can do with Jigso's Sidekick. Once again, if you want to try it out, it is totally free. There's a link in the description, and I'd appreciate it if you click that just to support the channel. Let me know if you have any questions or if you tried out and what you think. I'll definitely be hanging around the comment section and interacting with as many people as possible. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.